Captain, did you ever turn your ship upside down in a vain search for a key that did not exist?
I don't know what lies have been sworn to in this court, but I'd like to set you straight on this matter right here and now. A key definitely did exist.
May it please the court, the witness is understandably agitated by this ordeal, and I request a recess to give him a brief
I don't want a recess. I'll answer all questions right here and now.
Did you conduct such a search?
Yes, I did. As usual, my disloyal officers failed me, and the key couldn't be found.
As a matter of actual fact, wasn't this whole fuss over a quart of strawberries?
The pilfering of food in large amounts or small is one of the most serious occurrences on board ship.
Yes, but didn't you learn the mess boys had eaten the strawberries and that you were conducting a search for an imaginary key?
I repeat, the key was not imaginary. And I don't know anything about mess boys eating strawberries.
Captain, have you no recollection of a conversation with an Ensign Harding just prior to his leaving the Cane?
What about it?
Well, didn't Ensign Harding tell you that the mess boys ate the strawberries?
All that I remember is that he was very grateful for his transfer. His wife was ill in the States.
Captain, do you know where Ensign Harding is now?
Well, I have no way of knowing.
Ensign Harding is in San Diego. His wife is fully recovered. He has already been summoned and can be flown up here in 3 hours, if necessary. Would it serve any useful purpose to have him testify?
No. I don't see any need of that. Now that I recall, he might have said something about mess boys, and then again, he might not. I questioned so many men, and Harding was not the most reliable officer.
I'm afraid the defense has no other recourse than to produce Ensign Harding.
Now, there's no need for that. I know exactly what he'll tell you, lies. He was no different from any other officer in the wardroom. They were all disloyal. I tried to run the ship properly with a book, but they fought me at every turn. If the crew wanted to walk around with their shirt tails hanging out, that's all right. Let them. Take the tow line. Defective equipment. No more, no less. But they encouraged the crew to go around scoffing at me and spreading wild rumors about steaming in circles and then old Yellowstain. I was to blame for Lieutenant Merrick's incompetence and poor seamanship. Lieutenant Merrick was the perfect officer, but not Captain Queeg. Ah, but the strawberries. That's where I had them. They laughed at me and made jokes. But I proved beyond the shadow of a doubt and with geometric logic that a duplicate key to the wardrobe icebox did exist. And I'd have produced that key if they hadn't pulled the Cane out of action. I know now they were only trying to protect some fellow officer and... Naturally, I can only cover these things from memory. If I've left anything out, why, just ask me specific questions and I'll be glad to answer them one by one.
No further questions, sir.